started about 4 years ago as a street food company. We have this beautiful vintage 1962 Airstream trailer, and we outfitted it as a commercial kitchen. So it's got a big hood on the top, and it's like a jalopy. It rattles around town. My partner is a great chef, and our idea was to provide an experience of from chef to person great food for lunch. This was really revolutionary in Seattle at the time. We were providing food of a whole different caliber than you normally would associate with street food and taco trucks and so forth. So things like duck tacos and parpadel with sorrel and fresh peas were our standard fare, mussels with curry sauce. And it just blew the minds of folks in Seattle. And part of the fun, I think, of the whole Skillet street food experience is not knowing exactly where we're going to be in a predictable way. So people have to look for us. So we have a great following on Facebook and Twitter, and we put broadcasts out at the beginning of the week of what our schedule is going to be, and people actually will tailor their schedules to come and find us and have lunch with us. Some of the food blogs picked us up and started to write about this innovative product, Bacon Jam. And that was a total surprise. It was never intended to be a product. It was a condiment that Josh created to put on the burgers that we serve in Seattle. And people started to ask whether they could purchase it separately. Really, it's a very simple recipe, but it's basically pureed bacon with balsamic and brown sugar and onions. And we puree it to like the consistency of a chutney. So it's like spreadable bacon. You can just open the jar and spread it out. Word of mouth started to spread, and Martha Stewart somehow picked up our product and put it on her recommended list of Christmas food gifts. And we went from selling maybe 100 jars a month to 10,000 jars in 1 month. It was amazing. It was a really hard experience, but it taught us that we had something here that we needed to take seriously and start to develop as its own product, as a separate business. It's still very personal for us. We produce now in a much larger kitchen, but it's still supervised by us, and there's a lot of care and attention that goes into the production and the distribution of our product. So just the same way that we have this loyal following of people that eat at our truck in Seattle, we also have a loyal following of Bacon Jam aficionados who are just passionate about it.